Hello, 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 and today we are going to be doing an easy, stunning, teal, smoky eye. And I'm Linda Whitwer. I am not a makeup artist. I am a regular woman, and I have learned tips and tricks that help me feel beautiful, and I bring those to you to help you feel beautiful. Makeup doesn't make us beautiful, but if there's a few little things that we can do on the inside that give us a little more confidence, that does make us beautiful. So you saw yesterday's tutorial. I did a nice, simple, easy, classic look using the new Anniversary Addiction palette, which has, let me open it up here, some incredible colors. You have these three, which are great for a neutral eye, but you will use them in anything more dramatic. And then these amazing colors that are black pigment with a dual chromatic tone base. Let me see if I can get that in there so you can see those incredible colors. So I'm going to be using today Unashamed Beaming, a little bit of, which one is it? I got to see. A little bit and a little bit of Dazzling. Is that the teal? Yeah. To create this fabulous teal smoky eye. It is on trend. Metallics and glitter are on trend for the season. And as a more mature woman, I saw this and I really hesitated because it's really not that great for a, I didn't think, for a more mature woman. I didn't think I could pull it off. Then I saw how easy it was to do. And I don't know. I think I pulled it off. Now this is for when we're going out. So you can get glammed up, but you're not going to have just the winged liner and stuff. You can go for a nice smoky eye. When you close your lid, you're just going to get just a little bit of shimmer in that subtle duochromatic look. These are duochromatic, so they're going to look black, but then every once in a while they're going to look teal. You're going to get the flash of teal, kind of like a mermaid's tail. So let's go ahead and get started. Let me pull this in a little closer so you can see what I'm doing. Of course, I didn't bring a hair thing. So the first thing that's really important, and there are some general rules of thumb that are good to follow. What I've done is I've watched a number of other presenters create different looks and played with them and found the best, the easiest look to do. And that's what I want to share with you. So the first thing you want to do is prime your eyes. And this is our, Moodstruck Eye Primer, which is, feels weightless, which is really important to me. You're going to put that on your entire lid and bring it up to the top. And also down a little bit on the edges and under your eye. This keeps everything in place and it gives a nice smooth surface. It also prevents any creasing. And then I'm gonna start with the Unashamed for the transition color. So when working with these type of duochromatic glitter shimmers, it's really, you cannot blend them. If you blend them, you're going to create mud and make it look, kind of kill off the glitter. So what we do is we create a background of the smokiness and then apply the glitter on top. Didn't know that, did you? Also, we want to avoid any fallout. Now this does pretty well for not falling out. However, there is still a little bit of fallout because these are such heavily pigmented products. So there's two ways you can do it. One is to apply your concealer after, and then there's another way I'll show you later on in the week. So I'm going to take our blending brush, which is a nice fluffy blending brush, and I want to make sure that it's clean. So I use this Easy Swisher. You can get it on Amazon. It's just like a little sponge, and you can go like that and get any old product off your brush. I'm going to take a little bit of Unashamed on my brush. You can see there, very much. And then I'm going to, remember we talked about swish, stipple, and swirl. So we're gonna do a little bit of that. I'm gonna stipple first here where I want the product because that deposits the most product. And then I'm gonna swish back and forth. And I'm using a very light touch just to kind of get a little bit of transition area in here. So stipple, so I'm just stippling back and forth and then I swish back and forth. Okay, very lightly to get that lightly on my transition area. Now, I don't have very big eyes, so I have to be very careful where I apply the product. And then a little bit of swirling at the end just to blend out those edges. Okay, so you can see that. Then I'll take just a little bit down under my eye as well. Look up when you're doing this. Again, just a swish. Okay. So now I want to deepen that a little bit more so I can create this smoke. So all this smoke here is with Unashamed. And so I'm going to take our crease brush. Sorry, I have to put this down, which looks like this. It's a denser brush, it's more tightly packed, and it's finer, so I can do a more precise application. And once again, I'm gonna take Unashamed on the brush, and I'm going to bring it from the lash line up, and I'm stippling it into this corner or outer V of my eye, building that. Now, less is more, so it's important to take the time to build the product. You can always add to it to increase the drama, but it's very hard to take away. So I just build that product in, and I'm keeping it in that outer corner of my eye and in that crease, right below the crease bone, because I wanna draw my eyes up. My eyes are smaller, so you can see this eye looks much larger than this eye. So I'm just gonna stipple in here, bring it down to my lash line and up, and then again, a little bit under here. Now I've applied my foundation, but I have not applied any concealer under this eye. That way I can pick up any, clean up any fallout. And then I'm just gonna lightly blend it in. And now I'm going to do the little swirls, which are tiny little circular motions on the edges, just to blend them out, like that. I'm gonna put this down because my lids are a little looser. So I'm going to just kind of gently hold this off to the side and swirl and sweep. Very light, I'm holding it out, and I'm just very light touch just to blend out those edges. Okay, I'm not creating mud now. I've stippled it where I want it. Now I create the blend. So you can see how it's a little bit smoky here on the outside and then lighter into the inside. Okay, so now the fun part starts. So what we're gonna do, and this is included in the kudos that we have this month, which is the anniversary palette, the splurge cream shadow of your choice, the lipstick of your choice, and the cream shadow brush, which is the primary tool for this look. So I'm gonna use the splurge cream shadow in Assertive, which is this kind of shimmery green. Mine is, so you can see it right there. I'm gonna take it on your cream shadow brush. Down there, sorry, making all this clatter. And you're just gonna press it onto your mobile lid from the inner corner to the outer third. So I learned this, as I mentioned, I watch a number of different presenters who have much more skill than I in makeup application. And I watch them and I pick the look that I felt was the easiest to apply. And those are the ones that I'm bringing to you. So this, most of this look is from Alexis Michael, who is just a young co-ed. She just recently graduated from college. She paid for her college education while doing Unique and now has a nice little business that she's running because she's a marketing major. So it all fits right in to what she's doing. So this acts as your base for your glitter and it brings an extra depth to the color. It also gives that color something to stick. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but you want to put it from the inner corner to the outer third of your eye. Like that. Okay, so now I'm just gonna take a little bit off that brush, whatever's left of the splurge. It doesn't have to be completely clean because we're gonna use green, and I'm gonna use our setting spray. So if you apply these colors damp, it makes the colors pop more. In addition, it helps reduce fallout. So you can use the setting spray, you can use the rose water. I like the setting spray because it's used to set products, and I like that. You don't want your brush soaking wet, but you want it damp. So I spray a little bit onto the back of my hand and get my brush wet. Then I'm gonna go into dazzling and I'm gonna shimmy my brush into it. I'm not gonna just gently touch, I'm gonna shimmy it and really pack that color on. And then I'm going to pack that color on to my lid. You can see, I hope you can see with the light. It's just so pretty. And then I'll get a little more color. You can spray the brush if you want. I put it on the back of my hand or in a dish to get it. And it's important to pack the color on. Oops, excuse me, I didn't finish the sentence. I put it there because I don't get my brush too wet. But you can certainly spray your brush at first. And you can see I'm stippling it or dabbing it on. You don't want to brush it on or you will brush away the glitter. So can you see that? And now here's a nice little fun cheat. It's kind of funny because as kids we would do that. But I need to put my lid on my splurge. With your splurge cream shadows, you want to keep them well covered. You're going to blow on your finger and you're going to pick up a little bit more of that color. You can look at that. Oh, isn't that pretty? That's what's going to be catching your eye. And I'm going to just dab it onto my lid, into the center part of my lid. Can you see that? Just a nice subtle look. So you're gonna get this nice smoky looking eye. And then when you catch the light correctly, there's just gonna be this shimmer of teal, like a mermaid's tail. So I'm gonna take this off because I don't wanna get all over my shirt. And I don't recommend you wear what you're gonna wear when you put this on. I made the mistake of doing that, and I had my palette on the counter. I leaned up against it and got all those fabulous colors all over my top. Okay, so now that we have that there, I'm gonna take the blending brush again and come back in and take Ashamed, and I'm gonna smoke this out a little bit more. So I'm gonna tap, stipple, swirl into the corner, and then just sweep it across. But I'm gonna build that smoke now, okay? So I'm kind of sandwiching the pigments that I applied to my lid with the smoke in my corner. And I'm keeping it up high above my lid there. And then I'm going to come back with the crease brush and define that even further, building the smokiness just to the level of smokiness that you want. But I'm really avoiding blending any of that green pigment or the teal, except right in the crease, just a little bit on the edges to blur out those edges. You see that? It's really important to pack that color on there too. That's why using the setting spray works great, because it holds it there because it's designed to hold, but you want that pack so you get that density of color. You don't want it to be kind of a sheer coat because then you lose the effect. Okay, and then I'm gonna clean this brush off with my Simple Sweeper, and I'm going to go back in with Beaming, and I'm just going to use this to blend out above in here and just blend out the Unashamed a little bit into my eye, and it softens it a little bit. You see that? Just go back and forth till you get that color and intensity that you want. So it does take just a little bit of time, but really, we haven't been here that long and it's quite simple. And you want the overall effect to draw up, not down. So you want to pull this down. You want to come kind of in this area. And this next trick, which I show you what I'll do with the concealer, helps to accomplish that. So I do have a little bit of fallout. Okay, so what you're going to do for lashes, and you would want to apply your lashes before on the upper lashes before you do your concealer, although you don't have to. This is pretty dramatic. So a dramatic eye calls for dramatic lashes. So I do use Epic. Oops, I forgot a step. Before you apply your mascara, you should do one more thing. I do come in with either black, or I like to use our teal, or you could use Polar if you purchased it. It was a limited edition. And I just tightline my waterline. So it adds a little more drama to that pop of color. Then I'll come in with the mascara. I'm only gonna do the mascara on my upper lids. So I was prepping for this live. It's a funny story. And our dog has been scooting, so we had to go get her anal glands expressed. So I went to the vet with one eye smoked to get Luna's anal glands expressed. Fortunately I got to stay in the other room, but I looked a little odd. So now I'm going to do one coat of Epic, and then I come in and I do a quick coat of the 3D Plus gel. Just build the gel, fiber gel. The Epic makes a nice base for the gel. Keeps those lashes separated. Fibers to the tips. And if I was really going out, I probably would do two coats of 3D Plus, but I don't want to take too much of your time. See those lashes reaching up there? And then gel again to seal. It's very important to seal with gel. Just to the outer third of those lashes. Can you see? Looks like I need to blend this in a little bit here. I'm gonna take this and blend this in. Hope I'm not blocking you. There. Okay, so now let's look at the trick for down below. So I do have a little bit of fallout. I wanna clean it up. And then also I wanna even up this line here. So I'm going to take my concealer. I used Organza on this side to give a little more brightening. I'm gonna mix Organza and Chiffon. This is our cream concealer. A little goes a very long way. So I'm gonna mix a little of Chiffon, which is a lighter shade, or excuse me, Organza, which is the lighter shade, and Chiffon. Both have a slight pink undertone, which is not my look, but for under eye circles and brightening, it's great. And I'm just gonna, you can see I put it between two hands, and I'm just gonna dab it. This is the darkest corner, and I'm gonna dab it across here, oops, to clean up this area. Up in there. And then I take my blending bud, and I'm gonna spray it with rose water. You can also use the Behold setting powder if you want. Should be just slightly damp so it doesn't soak up any product. I'm gonna just press that into my skin. And this is where I clean up this edge. See that? So it's gonna brighten my under eye. Do my concealing. And then I take what's left on my foundation brush and just stipple that to make it more even. And that cleans up this corner right here. You see how sharp that is now? I do want to blur this out just a little bit. Oh, it's so pretty. Then for a little more definition under my eye, I'm gonna take a cream shadow brush, and you want it to be clean. I'm gonna take a little more beaming, and I'm just gonna bring it in under my brow, this inner corner. So fabulous. Now let's work on this under eye, because we need to smoke in and balance out that under eye. So I'm gonna come in with Unashamed on the crease brush, and I'm just gonna lightly smoke out my under eye. Stipple, sweep, looking up. See? And then I like to take, where is it? Did I not bring it? Oh. I take my liner shader brush and I'm gonna use a little more of the Behold setting powder. I'm gonna get the angled side wet. Just damp with the setting powder, and I'm gonna take a little bit of Dazzling. And I'm gonna just press it right onto my lash line to give that green smoke. But you definitely want it damp. I'm gonna pull it in like that. And then smoke it up into the corner. And then a little more Unashamed. Just to blend it out again. Smoking. Finish it with a little bit of Epic. Oops, let me take this off. I had more on my finger of the concealer. A little more Epic on the lower lash line. Hi, Sherry. Finish with a little bit of Epic on the lower lash line. So I've been using my Esteem Lash Serum religiously, and it does take a little bit of a wait, but it is worth it because my lashes are so much longer and thicker. I have ultra, ultra fine lashes. So when I say thicker, it's just that I have more lashes on my eyes. And then I'm just gonna use my Epic again on my upper lashes just to separate those lashes. Okay. So we've done the concealer, we've done the eye. I've done the concealer, I've done the face. We need to finish up the face. So I'm going to use a little bit of the Malibu bronzer just to warm up this section here under the cheeks and on the temples. And then let's go on to lips. Oh, I forgot the best part before I do lips. So Beaming, where did I put it? It's a very versatile color. So you will also use a little bit of Beaming. You can use your fingers or you could use a fan brush. But just to highlight . Don't highlight any expression lines. Oh, what did I do? I got a hair there. Just to get that extra highlight there. You see? It's an awesome color. I wish they'd make a pressed pigment like that because I'm gonna use a lot of it with other looks. Okay, so let's go to lips. Now I did put my Hottie on my lips. Just plump them up beforehand. And I am going to go for a nude lip. So with a bolder eye, you want a couple things. You do need to go slightly bolder with your brow because it will wash out and you'll lose the drama. So if I don't know if you noticed at the beginning, but when I came on and I didn't have makeup on this eye, this brow looked a little bit odd. Aw, thank you, darling. Thank you, darling Sherry. So we're gonna do a nude lip. This is my favorite nude lip. I am going to use Prim, which is kind of they call it a chocolate brown. I think I mentioned that before, but it's a taupey brown and I love it. I love to define my lips with it because it really makes them pop. You could also use Plush, which is a fabulous color. It has a little bit of a mauve-y tone to it. So I don't know if you can see that. But my preference is Prim. I use Prim most of the time. Prim can also double for your brows too, and a subtle eyeliner. So I'm going to overdraw my lips. You can see here on my lips, I have where my color ends, and then you can see the ridge, which is nice and fluffy because of my Hottie. So I'm gonna go to the ridge and overdraw most of my lips here and here, but bringing it into the corner. So my lips look fuller, but I can't talk while I'm at this part. So when we're overdrawing our lips, you can come up above the colored edge, so to that ridge, but you always want to finish at the color in the corner, and that's what gives it that realistic look instead of that fake inflated look. Now underneath, again, see that ridge here? I'm going to go there, but bring it into the corner. See? And then I'm gonna fill in the corners with the dark Prim just to give a little more interest to it. And now, well-to-do is a classic nude shimmer. It's one of our most popular colors, you can see. It's very, did I put it anywhere? Oh, it's right there. It's very subtle. I'm just gonna apply that to my lip. Mine is a little crooked because I broke it. And then I'm gonna take a brush. Where's my regular brush? Make sure it's clean. Just gonna blend out the edges a little to soften it. And there you have it, a complete look. So here's the thing. We have an anniversary edition bundle, which is the Addiction palette, the lipstick of your choice, and these lipsticks are so hydrating. They've got mango butter. They feel so rich and they're very long lasting. The the palette, the lipstick, the Splurge Cream Shadow, and the Cream Shadow Brush for $85, which is an incredible value, but also because you guys have been so good to me over the years and supportive, and I told you this is my way of saying thank you. Anyone who purchases this, kudos, will also get, I will send you a blending brush for free. And this is a brush that you definitely want to have in your arsenal. So if you want any help picking out colors, let me know. I'm going to come back and show you later how we can use some more of these incredible colors. They're so pretty. I think I'm going to do this one next, or maybe the purple. So thanks for joining in. You guys have a wonderful Sunday, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.